Okay, so hello everyone. Welcome. Can you hear me?
Yes, hello.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Hello.
Okay, thank you. Okay.
Hello to everyone.
Okay, so hello everyone. Welcome from different countries. So basically, today is our third number of class. Okay, and we only cover our first day and second days. And I hope you already get the practice code as well also get the recorded video class. Okay, so basically today is our third number of class. So now we'll start. So I simply share my screen. Okay, so now can you see my screen?
No, sir, it is not visible. Yeah, now it is visible.
Okay, so let's go. So hi and welcome. So basically today is our third number of class. So basically in this class I will try to discuss about that how we can easily calculating any indices from the satellite images. Okay, any indices, any kinds of indices. It can be long equation or small equation, any types of equation, how we can easily solve in Google Earth Engine platform. From the, it also called the raster calculation. So how we can easily do the different types of equation and also make the raster calculation in Google Earth Engine platform for the different equation. Then we also try to discuss about the land surface temperature monitoring. So mainly we can calculate the land surface temperature monitoring using the MODIS satellite images as well as also Landsat imagery. It also possible to use the Sentinel free satellite imagery. But in this online training program, I will show you that MODIS and Landsat imagery, how we can easily use and then make the land surface temperature monitoring. After that, we also try to discuss about the filtering and displaying the satellite images, mainly Sentinel-2. And then using the Sentinel-2 satellite images, how we can easily monitor the normalized difference water index. Okay. After that, we also try to discuss about that how we can easily make the time series chart. Okay. We already know about the one kind of time series chart for ready-made dataset, whose band is already created in the Google Earth Engine data catalog. So this type of band, how can we create the time series chart, we already know. But in this time, we are using it the raw satellite images, such as Landsat, Sentinel, then make the different types of indices. And then we also try to show you that how we can easily make the time series chart using the NDVI, NDWI, or other indices, any indices. And then how to export any shape file from the Google Earth Engine platform. In Google Earth Engine platform, we can easily export any types of shape file. We also try to discuss about this part. And then how to add the gradient legend. Okay, so legend, mainly we can add the two type of legend. One legend is the class legend, another legend is the gradient legend or color bar legend. So we also try to discuss about that, how we can easily add the gradient legend. And then how to calculate from the MODIS and Landsat data, NDWI. So mainly it's the ready-made data set already available in Google Earth Engine platform. I also try to show you that. Okay, so let's go. So first of all, we try to discuss about the calculating any indices, then move to the land surface temperature. So let's go. I simply open my code editor. I select my email, which I used. Okay, so in this time, suppose I want to choose an image collection, any image collection. Suppose I want to work with for the Landsat imagery. So then I simply go to the Landsat imagery. And then here I find out all of those Landsat image collection. Suppose I want to work for the Landsat 8. So simply go on the Landsat 8. So here I find out all of those Landsat 8 image collection. So I want to work for the top of atmospheric. So basically when you want to identify the different types of indices, top of atmospheric, it's better for calculating the different types of indices. And when you want to make the land use land cover classification, then surface to plate is better. Okay. So now I simply choose the top of atmospheric or TOA reflectance, top of atmospheric reflectance, this image. Here I find out all of this image information, image provider, Earth Engine effect, all of those things we can get in here. So in this time, first of all, I just simply copy this Earth Engine effect from here. Simply copy and then paste in my code editor. First, I imported my image collection. Okay, I simply imported the image collection and then give a variable name. Suppose I put the variable name is that L8. Okay, and in this time, I simply give I simply filter this image collection. And we already know about the filtering process. Filtering mainly defined where, then how, and then when is the time. Okay, so three factors we need when you want to filter. So in this time, suppose I need this satellite image for a specific region. Suppose I simply select this point. Suppose this is my area of interest. Okay, so this is my area of interest. For this area of interest, I want to calculate the NDVI. So that's why I find out my where. So this is my where. I put this name is that suppose RY. You can use any name. There is no problem. So then I simply take a variable. Suppose I put the variable name is the image. Okay. And then call my full image collection LA. So simply copy. Basically this image collection is stored the image collection for the whole world. But in this time I don't need for the whole world. I need the image collection for this region. So for that I simply use a function. Filter bounds function. Okay, filter bounds. And what is my geometry? In this time, my geometry is that area, which is stored in the variable name is that ROI. So simply use that the ROI. Okay, so I put my answer about the hair. Then how? So this answer, we can put this input different way. Okay, suppose in this time, you want to find out for this region, which image is the lowest cloud cover. You want to find out that. Or suppose I use at this, suppose when, suppose I simply put this time period, suppose filter date function, suppose year of 2020, 1st January, from year of 2020, December 31. So in this time period, I want to find out for this region, the lowest cloud cover image, okay? Between this time period, I want to find out the lowest cloud cover image for this region. So for that, I need to use a function, this function called the short function, okay? Mainly short is a function, it also used instead of the filter metadata, okay? Instead of filter metadata, we are also using here the short function. In this time, I want to short it, for that it will be give me the image, which image is the lowest cloud cover for this region, between this time period, okay? So I put here the short and then put here this image properties, suppose cloud cover, this is my properties, and then put here the first function, okay? So in this time, between this time period, year of 2020, for this region, what is the lowest cloud cover image, I find out. So I simply print that. You can see in this time, I can get only for the one image. So I simply copy the variable and paste here and use the size function. And then click to the run, it's showing me only for the one image for this region. And this image, okay, just a minute. Check it, just a minute. So it's showing the print. Okay, so I just simply copy the image. So in this time, it not work. In this time, size is not a function because size is mainly determined how many images. Okay, in this time here I can get only for the one image, so that's why size is not work for that. Okay, so just I simply print that I can get only for the one image, and this image is the lowest cloud cover image. You can get all of those information about the image acquisition date, all of those things you can get from here. You can see, so first of all, I can get the image acquisition date is the year of 2020, 21 February. Okay, and I can get all of those band. You can also check the properties. You can see cloud cover is the 0.01. It means that for this region, between this time period, I got the 0.01. It is the lowest cloud cover image for this region. If you want to check the other region, then simply drag and put this marker another region. Suppose I put this in here. and then click the run. So in this time, I find out this region, what is the lowest cloud covered for this region between the time period year of 2020. So now check about that. You can get the acquisition date is that 2020, 2nd August. And also you can see the time period is the 0.1, okay, for this region. So mainly we are using it the short and fast function. When you want to find out for the lowest cloud cover image for any region, any specific time period, you want to find out it, okay? So you can simply drag and open it another region, then it's showing the about this region. And basically it's showing the tiles. If I add the layer of this image, then it also better. So I simply add the map.addLayer function and call the image and click the run. So in this time, it also added the layer of a tiles of this image. You can see it will add the tiles. And this tiles acquisition time is that we can find out this in here, as well as we can also check about the cloud cover. And this is the lowest cloud cover image for this region between the time period year of 2020, okay? We can get the 0% cloud cover for this region, okay? So if you want to add the visualization, suppose I add the visualization from here. So just I simply put here the suppose red, then suppose put here the green, and finally I add the blue, okay? Custom as 98% stress for better looking, and then apply. So now this vision will be added with that images. And this image is the 0% cloud cover. And this is the time period about the acquisition time about this image. Okay. So this is the process when you want to find out for the lowest cloud cover image for any specific region with a specific time period. Okay. So now you want to use this image for different types of work, such as make the NDVI, make the land use land cover classification, make the any types of remote sensing work you can do. Okay. So now anyone any question about that, you can ask me.
Yes, a question.
Yeah, please.
So instead of replace of sort, can you use a filter metadata in order to remove out area or to sort out cloud cover?
Yeah. Okay, so basically in this time when I want to use at the short function, short mainly used for one element or one properties. So in this time it's shorting. Shorting means that it will be start from the lowest, suppose 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that. So in this time I use at the short function and use at the only for the one element or one properties. Using these properties, I take the first image. First means that the lowest, which will be start from the lowest cloud cover for this shorting list. So in this time, between this time period, we can get a lot of images, but I short it according to the cloud cover and find out the lowest cloud cover image using the first function. Okay?
So another question.
Yeah, please.
Is it not possible at the level of cloud cover to specify the percentage of cloud cover? Maybe you can say cloud cover less than 10% cloud cover, less than that.
Okay, so for that, when you want to specify it, I already discussed about this for our previous class. You need to use the filter metadata. Okay, so filter metadata, then you have to use here, suppose this function. Suppose I use the filter metadata and then put here the cloud cover, my element name, cloud cover, and put the operator less than, and then you can simply put at the specific value, suppose 1 or 0.5 or any value you want to put in here. Then it will be filtered according to your specific range for the cloud cover. Okay, but in this time we are not using at the specific range, we are just using at the short function and then find out the lowest cloud cover image. But when you want to do for the specific range of the cloud cover, then you need to put here this filter metadata function. Okay, for selecting the specific range of the cloud cover. Okay, any question?
Hello.
Yeah, please.
Why did you use a first function?
First function we mainly use in this time. I want to find out for this region what is the lowest cloud cover image. Okay, between the time period, and you don't know between the time period for this region what is the lowest cloud cover image. I don't know, But when a user the short function and user the fast function, then it will be appear at the lowest cloud covered image for this region within this time period. Okay.
So each time we use a short function, we have to use also fast function.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yes. Okay.
I'm experiencing an issue, so I put my problem here.
In addition that you have example filter date. Okay, so filter date, I think you are also mistake in the spelling or also the notation about that. So filter date, you just no, write.
So
in,
if you,
yeah, you can see filter
date. Yeah, when you, yeah. Yeah, yeah, not for filter date. For example, when you write code on the filter bound ROI, and then when you hit enter, then so mine starts from the like very beginning, it's like the node tab or. So, but here, so you had like it was like it is below just like LA. So it works sometimes, and then sometimes it starts from the like very beginning. So yeah, I wonder. So what causes that?
Okay, so can you share your screen, then I'll check it about this problem.
Impossible,
after this session, we also discuss for the 1 hour for the problem solving class. So then I it also better.
Okay, yeah.
So after the 1 hour for today's session, we can talk about that, about the problem. And also share your screen, then also discuss. Okay, so let's go continue. Okay, so this is the process when you want to find out for any specific region or is any specific time period for the lowest cloud covered image. Then we have to use the short function and then fast. So now I find out this image look like that. I also imported the visualization in my code editor. So for that, I can simply import it, use the import. Okay, just a minute. I think some networking issue for my side. Okay, just a minute. Okay, I think this it's not loaded in this time because it will be hang and some need to measure. So just I simply write the code again, just a minute. Okay. So same way, I simply go to this in here. Okay. Okay, loaded. Okay, sorry for some networking issue. Just simply copy again and write the code again. So now run the code again. So now I can get this image for this region, and which image is the lowest cloud cover image for this time, we can get in here. So I add the visualization in this time for get the true color composite. So you add this red, then green, and also put at the blue. Custom is the 98% for better looking. I simply apply and now import. Okay, so after simply copy this variable name and paste after the object name. So this is your object placed in here. I put the layer name, suppose true color. Okay, true color composite. So now it will be okay. So now this color will be set. So in this time, I want to, okay. Why it not set? So before red, then green, and blue, custom 98%, apply, and also import. Okay, so just I simply copy again. Yeah, sorry for that. It will be add in here the map.add layer, not print. Okay, so now it's okay. We now click to the run, it will be set with our code and the visualization. Okay, so now you can see this image I got in here. So using this satellite image, so now I want to identify different types of indices, any kind of indices. Okay, so in this time we talk about that how we can easily calculate any types of indices. It can be NDVI, it can be NEWI, it can be DCI, TCI, any kinds of indices, how we can easily calculate. Just you should know what is the equation, what is the formula of your indices. Then we can easily calculate any types of indices and also find out the result. Okay, so let's go. So for calculating any indices, when you can calculate about the indices, first of all, we should know about the formula. Suppose in this time I talk about that NDVI, okay? So NDVI formula is that near infrared band minus red band divided by near infrared band plus red band. Okay, so this is our formula. When you want to implement this formula on the satellite images, then it will be showing the result about the NDVI, or normalized difference vegetation index. Suppose when you want to calculate the NDWI, just simply put here the NDWI formula. You want to implement the VCI, TCI, or EVI, or suppose EVI, okay, or also put here the soil moisture index, anything, SMI. Suppose you want to implement here the VSI, vegetation health index. So any kind of index, when you want to implement that, first of all, you have to know about the formula, about this index. So let's go about that. Or also suppose you want to calculate that EVI or enhanced vegetation index. So any kind of index when you want to calculate in Google Earth Engine platform, first of all, you have to know about the formula. So in this time, suppose NDVI, I want to calculate from this satellite images. In Google Earth Engine platform, we can calculate the NDVI in the different way. More than five way, we can calculate that. For the five different approaches we can use and calculate that. So I will teach you all of those approaches so that you can easily calculate any types of equation. So let's go about that. So first of all, I talk about the first approach. Okay, you can use any one, but I show you all of those approaches or first step. Okay, so our first approach. So let's go. So first of all, we are using a function. This function called the normalized difference. So it is a function, and this function called the built-in function. This function already created in Google Earth Engine platform. This function already created in the Google Earth Engine platform. So mainly when I use this function, it automatically calculated the first minus second divided by first plus second. Okay, so this is the normalized difference function. this function already created in Google Earth Engine platform. So when I use it, this normalized difference function, it automatically calculated the first minus second divided by first plus second. It can be anything, suppose near minus red or near plus red or any band. So let's go about that. So first of all, I use add that. So take a variable. Suppose I put the variable name is the NDVI. Okay. And then call my image. I want to work on this image. So I simply call this image. You can see this image is stored in a variable in here. Simply copy that and paste in here. So I simply call my image. In this image, I want to apply the normalized difference function. Okay, this is the function, normalized difference function. In this time, I mention here the first and second band. I want to work for the NDVI. So for that, I want to use here the near and red. So for that, I can simply put here the near infrared band is that B5, and put here the red band is that B4. Okay, in this image you can see, the near infrared band is that B5, and red band is the B4. So you use here these two band and put here. So now it calculated the NDVI. I show the result. So use add the map dot add layer and call the NDVI and click the run. So in this time it added the layer about the NDVI for this image. So you can see it added the layer, but this image it not look as a, it's showing as a grayscale color. So I want to add here the visualization. So for that, what can I do? I just make a curly bracket and put here the minimum pixel value of NDVI. It will be start from the negative one. And the maximum pixel value of NDVI up to 1. And put here this filleted function. Suppose I am to show the negative pixel value as a water for the blue color. And then water I use at this white color for showing the build-up area or barren land and other things. And green, I want to show as the green color for the vegetation. Okay, so now click to the run. In this tab, it's showing the NDVI map for this region. So these are satellite images and other layer showing the NDVI map. Okay, you can see it's showing the water body as the blue color. Okay, there is the no vegetation about that. We can also get the, you can see the crop plan about that. Okay, more vegetation about this region. Okay, if you want to check about that value, suppose click on the inspector tab and click on the water body, then you can get the, check the result about that. You can see this result showing that result negative 0.29. It's showing the ND. So basically it's showing the default as the ND. But when I put here the rename function, suppose rename and put this name as the NDVI and click the run. So now in this tab, when I am to check the value using the inspector tab, it's showing the result NDVI. You can see, I simply click on this map for the vegetation. You can see what the NDVI value for this coordinate. We can find out this value in here, NDVI 0.7. For water body, we can get this coordinate. For this coordinate, what is the NDVI value we can get in here? You can see negative 0.3. Okay, so this is our NDVI map. In this step, we normally use here the normalized difference function. First approach. Okay, then define our band name. But it has the one problem is that mainly this function work only for the two band. Okay, suppose near infrared and then infrared. But when we have any equation, this equation has a more than two band or have some constant value or have some other types of constant value is also available. Suppose you can see about the equation. Suppose SAVI, soil adjusted vegetation index, about the formula. Index formula, SAVI index formula. So you can see this is SAVI index formula about that. Okay, so in this sub-index formula, you can get the band 4, band 3, and also get the constant value, 0.5, 1.5. So this type of constant value, we can also get in here. As well as also, you can see the EVI formula, enhanced vegetation index formula. So here you can see more than 3 band, band 4, band 3, band 3, band 1. Okay, also you can see some constant value, 6, 7.5, also 1. Okay, so this type of index, when you want to calculate that, then we also need to approach the another formula, another is so let's get about that. But normal difference is okay when you want to calculate any indices from two band. Okay, then it's okay. Second step is that, okay, so I also talk about the second approach. And in this time, suppose if you want, you can use the directly equation. Suppose you can take a variable ndvi, and your equation is that suppose near minus suppose red divided by near plus red. Okay, if you want, you can use this function directly, but before that we also need to add the some Google Earth Engine server function, because in Google Earth Engine minus is not a function in the server function. Instead of minus, we need to use at this subtract function. Okay, subtract with red band, and also not available for the division, it will be divide. We need to write the function divide with near add with red. Okay, so this function need to write. Okay, about that, in this time if you want to mention what is the near, what is the red, then it will be solved. So let's go about that. So for that, I simply take a variable. I put the variable name suppose near. Okay, in this variable I stored the near band. Okay, so basically you can see this image. This image has total how much band? You can see this image has stored all of those bands. Total 17 bands are available. Okay, in this time from this image I need to select for the near band. Near band is the B5 and red band is the B4. Okay, so for that, what can I do? I simply copy the variable name image, because it stored all of those band, and paste here. And from there I just select the band of B5. Okay, as well as also take another variable suppose red, and in this variable I also call the all of those images. From this image I select only for that B4 band. Okay, so now it's okay. So now I show the result. So for that I simply take the variable suppose add the layer, map dot add layer, call the suppose ndvi. Suppose I put the ndvi suppose 1. I put the another variable, so that's why it will be okay 1. Then click to the run. In this time another map or another layer also added in here, we can get the same result, but this approach is the different. Okay, in this time we use the direct equation. Okay, so this is another approach we can use here, the directly equation look like that, and when you add the color then it's also showing the look like that. And third step, third approach is that we need to use the expression. Third for that, okay, expression. So expression, so how in this term how I can define the expression in Google Earth Engine platform. So for that, take a variable, suppose put the variable name is that ndvi2, and I simply call my image. So I simply call my image for define the expression, call the image and paste here, and use here the select function, sorry, use here the expression function, expression. Okay, in this time in expression I need to define my equation. Okay, so normal equation, what is the equation? You can see near minus red divided by near plus red. Okay, this is my equation. I simply write the my equation look like that. Also I mentioned here the bracket. Okay, so that's why I put this, and this is my equation. I write my equation look like that. In this time I need to use here comma sign and make the curly bracket. In this curly bracket I need to define what is the near, what is the red. Okay, so as a dictionary, so near, so in this term what is the near? Okay, near is the near infrared band, and where the come the near infrared band? Near infrared band come from this image. So I use here the select and put here the B5, as well as also put here the red band, and where is it come? It's come from the image, and use here the select function and put here the B4. Okay, so now in this time you can see I simply put my equation near minus red, anything you can put as a variable, and then put here what is the near, what is the red, just mention about that. Okay, now simply add the layer, map dot add layer, and call the ndvi2, simply copy and click run. And again, another error is also added in here. We can get also the result about that. Okay. So this is the process. In this time, suppose I put anything. Suppose I put here the A minus B divided by A plus B. Okay. So now I define what is the A, what is the B. I need to define. So I use here the A. A is the band 5. So I simply call my image because this image is stored all of those band. From there, I select only for the B5 band. Also put the same things. What is the B? B is the red band. So I simply call my image because it is stored all of those band. From that, I select only for the red band. Now click to the run, I can get the same result about that. Okay, so now I guess we can get the result look like that. And when you add the color, then we can also get the colorful map to look like that, which I already show you this for that colorful map. You can see this is the colorful map we can easily get in here. Okay, so this is the process, and another approach is the fourth approach. I have to show you that for the sentinel. When I talk about the sentinel for next step, then I hope you can get the fourth step. So basically, when you can calculate any types of indices, so in the meantime, I also put in here the some homework or assignment. Okay, so I also put in our Google Classroom about the indices such as SAVI index or EVI index, how can you calculate. So you also try to for own self for calculating this type of equation, which are mainly in this time we need to use the expression. Okay, using this expression, we need to use this type of formula and then easily get the result for the EVI index or SAVI index or any other types of indices, how can you easily calculate in Google Earth Engine platform. So using this mainly for third step, we can show you that. So one is the normalized difference. So mainly we said the normalized difference, it famous when you want to talk only for the two band. Then if you want, you can also use at the Drake equation about that, as well as if you want to use at the expression. Just in the expression, put your formula, and then you define what is the variable. Suppose in this time A and B, what is the A and what is the B? Just simply mention about that, and then get the result about this. Okay, for anyone any question, you can ask me. Anyone any question about that? Okay, so kindly mute that, otherwise it will be suspicious. Is there any question or any doubt?
Hello?
Yeah, please.
Yes, what's the difference from between the NDVI we calculate now and that we did last class?
For NDVI?
Yeah, we export a NDVI map last class.
Okay.
In the past class.
Okay.
So I want to know the difference between.
Okay, so first class we are using at the modis satellite images. Okay, so today I will show you the Landsat images about that, and after that I will show you the sentinel imagery, how can you do for the sentinel. Okay, using the sentinel imagery, modis has the also have the NDVI, it also collect from the NDVI ready-made product, we also talk about that. Okay.
Yes.
Oh, MODIS is the different way. I also try to show you that for the MODIS. Okay, MODIS is the totally ready-made data set, which you already get in the Google Earth Engine platform. Okay, we don't need to calculate anything about look like it in the when you want to talk about the MODIS.
Okay. So between MODIS data and the Landsat 8 data, what's the better?
Landsat is better. Of course, Landsat is better because Landsat is the low resolution. You can get the high resolution satellite image in Landsat only for the 30 meter. And if possible, when you want to get the current situation analysis, then also Sentinel is also more better. With 10 meter resolution, you can get in here. Also high. Yeah.
Okay.
So, question.
Yeah, please.
I want to ask. Is it possible to to improve on the spatial resolution of an image before doing, performing or computing any analysis. For example, you can do the pan sharpening in order to improve the spatial resolution of the image before performing your analysis.
Yes.
On Google Earth Engine.
So in Google Earth Engine platform, we can use here the minimum high resolution Sentinel. Okay, Sentinel is better, but Sentinel is not, we can get the historical data set. Okay, so this is another problem for the Sentinel. Okay, then we have to move to the Landsat imagery. Okay, we can get the historical data in Landsat imagery. Okay, but Sentinel is the highest resolution. Okay, 10 meter resolution you can get in here for the Sentinel imagery. But from the Sentinel, you can get the year of 2015. Okay, from the year 2015 or 16, this time a year, we can get from the Sentinel imagery about it. Okay. Okay, so basically RGB is that red, green, and blue band. Okay, so yes, so it has also some rule about that RGB, or also true color composite or false color composite about that. So for that, you can also learn about this from this website. I also mentioned that suppose land band combination. So different band combination or different spectral indices has the different types of things added in here. So just a minute, I simply open the link. So here you can see, simply go, I also send the link, just a minute, then you can also read about the link, then you can easily get about the band combination, and which band combination provide you which information. You can see the result. Suppose you can see that, you can see, this is the natural color, so red, green, and blue, so it's called the natural color, okay, and mainly when you want to find, get this, use this band combination, then it mainly replicate close to what our human eyes can see. Okay, and healthy vegetation is the green, and in the flora is brown, urban feature appear the white, and gray and water is the dark blue or black when you are using this type of band combination, red, green, and blue. Okay, so after that you can see color infrared, it called the color infrared. So mainly the near infrared, red, and also green. Okay, near infrared, red, and green. So mainly when you are using this type of band combination, it's showing the result as they, you can see, is it mainly useful for the vegetation analysis. And it also have the red band have the better vegetation, okay, which means the red, better vegetation about the red color. Okay, dark areas are water and urban area are white color. Okay, this is the urban area, the white color. Okay, as well as also you can see the short wave infrared when you are using here the 764 short wave infrared 2, short wave infrared 1, and red. So mainly it also describe about that, and also you can see agriculture mainly when you want to use there the this type of band combination, short wave infrared 1, near infrared, and blue. It mainly used for the crop monitoring because it is used for the short wave infrared and near infrared. And healthy vegetation appears the dark green. Okay, but also you can get this type of magenta color about the barren land or fallow land about that. So when you use that, then we can get the result look like that. As you can see, geology, when you want to find out the any geological feature, then this band combination is the better. When you want to find out the any types of geological feature, and also bathymetric, you can see the bathymetric, when you want to find out the any bathymetric feature in the coastal band, we can use in here for the 431. Okay, as well as the panchromatic, we can also use here about that vegetation index, we can also talk about that. Okay, for the NDVI moisture index. Okay, so different types of band combination or different types of index, it help you for identify the different types of feature from the satellite images. Okay, and also help you for getting the information from here. So just you can simply go to this link and also check about all of those details. And also you can see the description about that visible near infrared. Also check the wavelength resolution. Okay, then also read on the full paper. Then I hope you can easily get idea about that, which band combination, which information provide about that. Okay, I will send the link in here, so then you can get the online. Okay, thank you. Okay, so now we talk about the Sentinel imagery. Okay, how we can easily filtering the Sentinel to satellite imagery, as well as also filtering and also displaying the different types of indices. It can be NDVI, NWI, or other types of indices using the Sentinel-2 serialization theory. Okay, so let's go. So, okay, so just I simply open a new code editor. Okay. So in this time, I simply open my data catalog and go to the Sentinel. And from that, I want to use for the Sentinel-2 satellite image multi-spectral instrument. And after that, open here the top of atmospheric surface distributor for the land use land cover classification and calculate the indices we are using at the top of atmospheric is also better. But we are also, the filtering process is the same, okay? So I also try to show you that later when I talk about the land use land cover classification, then I also try to show you. So now the top of atmospheric, let's go. Okay, so basically this resolution is mainly we can get the resolution for the 10 meter, some band you can see, the 10 meter, B2, B3, B4, some 20 meter, B5 is a 20 meter, okay? So in this time, I use this image collection and then find out for the for any region, what is the condition of the water on the surface for the different period, such as rainy season as well as the dry season. Okay, what is the condition of the surface water? Okay, so let's go about that. So for that, what can I do? Just I simply copy this. First of all, I simply copy about my collection and paste here. Okay, then give a variable name. You can use any variable name. I put the variable name, suppose Sentinel-2. Okay, so now my image collection is stored in here. So in this time, I want to find out this analysis for any specific region. Suppose I want to find out the analysis for Dhaka city. So just I simply import the Dhaka city boundary shape file. This is my region. I put the shape file variable name such as ROI. Okay, so now this image collection, I just need to filter. Okay. So two time period, such as the wet season and dry season. So let's go. So take a variable name. Suppose I put the variable name is that image dry. Okay, you can use any variable name. Then simply copy that. Our full image collection name is that Sentinel-2 and paste here. It intersecting. So use at the filter bounds with my region of interest, ROI, okay? So now I can simply put at this suppose image a specific time period. So use at the filter date function. Suppose I want to observe the result for the year of 2020, 1st January, and put at the 2020 January, February, March. Okay, put at this March, suppose 30. Okay. And then also put at this filter metadata and put here this image properties name. Suppose I put here this image properties cloud pixel percentage. So I simply copy that and paste and put here this less than, suppose less than one. Okay, so now we can check how many images I have got for this time. So I simply use here this print function and call the image by use here the size function, click run. So for my region, I can get the 20 images for this time period, January to March. Okay, in this time, if you want, you can get the median composite, just use here the median function. Okay, and display the result. Okay, or if you want, you can also take the another way. This way is that if you want, you can use here the short function. Suppose I put here the short function. Use here the short. Okay, in this time I short according to the cloud pixel percentage. Cloud pixel percentage. And if you want, you can take here the first image. Okay, first image mainly showing that result, which is the lowest cloud covered image. Okay, it's showing the first image. Okay, but in this time I am not using as the first image. In this time, after using here the cloud pixel percentage, all of those images, I can get total 48 images. All of those 48 images I mosaic. So I just make the mosaic from the total 48 images. So for that I use that the mosaic function. Mosaic. And what is the mosaic? You want to check about that mosaic. We already know about the median or all about things. So just simply drag and paste in here for the mosaic. So you can see mosaic, mainly it make a composite all of the images in a collection using the max. So composite all the images in a collection using the max way. So in this time I use the mosaic, and after that clip with my shapefile. So clip with my shapefile is that ROI. Okay, so now display the result about this. So use add the map dot add layer and call the image drive. Simply copy and paste. And after that, okay, I also need to focus the center of the shapefile. Map dot center object is that ROI and 10, okay, not 5. Click to the run. So now it's showing the result about our image for my study area of Dhaka. Okay, so I also increasing the zoom level, such as 12. So now I can say I can get the result look like that. Okay, so in this time I need to add here the visualization, otherwise it look like that. So for that, what can I do? Simply click on here. So I set the band combination such as red, then green, and also put the blue, range custom 98%, and then apply it. So now it added the visualization in my map, but I can get lot of cloud, you can see. Okay, all of this cloud and joining in this time in this image. Okay, so what can I do in this time? Okay, so in this time I can get a lot of cloud. When all of this cloud it merge in this image, for removing all of this cloud in this time, after the short function cloud pixel percentage, I use a boolean operator. This boolean operator is called the false color, false boolean operator. So now I hope it will be remove all of this cloud and we can get the very clear satellite images. So now I check again. So click on here, P4, red, then green, and also put here the blue. Then custom at 98% for better looking and apply. So now all of this cloud will be removed and we can get the clear satellite images for this time period. You can see. So I can get the image look like that. Okay, so now we can use the image for any kinds of work. It can be land use land cover, it can be vegetation index or normalized difference water index, anything you can do. Okay, so after that I also imported the image collection. So it imported and then simply copy and paste after the object name. So just paste. Okay, just in this time I can get the image collection for the dry season. So in this time it gets the image for the dry season. Okay, so in this time I also do for the same code and apply for the rainy season. Okay, so I put add this name such as dry image. Okay, you can use any name, and then simply copy the same code. And now I use the same code for the image dry rainy season or wet season. So for that, what can I do? Just I simply paste in here the same code, just something change in the time period. And also change the variable. Suppose put at the image for the wet season or rainy season, wet season, and put at the time process as 06. Okay, and then put at this October. Okay, so now put same things, then simply put at this image wet, click the run. So now I can get the image for the rainy season or wet season. Okay. Okay, but in this time when you want to work for the rainy season, then I find out some cloud look like that, you can see. So this type of cloud we can get in here. But dry season, there is no problem. We can get the very clear satellite images. But when I open this image in the rainy season, then I can find out some cloud. But this type of cloud, we can easily remove in Google Earth Engine platform using the cloud max band function. Okay, so I also try to show you the next class, next class, I also try to show you that how we can easily remove the cloud from the satellite images. Okay, so now you can see we can get the two images. Okay, I also change the layer name. One image for the dry season, another image for the wet season or wet image. So mainly we can find out the different types of unnecessary pixel values such as cloud, and also get the some cloud shadow in this image for the wet season image. Okay, so that's why it also hampered our analysis. So that's why you also need to remove this type of cloud and also remove this type of cloud shadow. Okay, so this class, I also try to discuss how we can easily remove the cloud from the satellite images, Landsat and Sentinel, both of satellite images, how we can remove this type of cloud. Okay, you can see this is the rainy season image, so you can find out the white pixel level as a cloud in here. Okay, so now I can get the two time period images in here for the rainy season and dry season.
Please, I have a question.
Yeah, please.
Yes, yeah. Maybe for example, if you have two dry seasons in the year, how can we express that?
How I can?
Yes. In the filtered date function.
Yeah, filtered date, yeah.
For example, if we have, for example, two dry seasons in the year.
Yeah.
For example, after that, we have November and December in the same year. We have also a dry season. How can we express that here?
Okay, so basically in this time, this time period depends on your region. Okay, so in this time, for the perspective of Bangladesh, we can get the rainy season or wet season between this time period. Okay, and for the dry season, this is the dry season for this perspective of Bangladesh. That's why I use here this dry season time period and also summer season about this, and also the rainy season or wet season in this time period input in here. Okay.
My question is that.
Please, let me explain this to him. Teacher, he wants to know, for example, in the same year, for example, in Benin, we have three seasons, two dry seasons and one wet season.
Okay.
So he wants to know if how we can deal with these three seasons here.
Yes.
Three season, you want to make the one combine about that. Okay, so then we need to equate. So already we can get the answer, you can see. Then we need to use at this e filter calendar range. Okay, so this function we need to put in here, e filter calendar range. Then we can easily get this our specific season about that. You can see about this. So I simply put in here calendar range. Okay, so you can see this function we need to use instead of the filter date function. Just put here the e filter to the calendar range, and then put here the start and end, and then you also define your field. Okay, field in this time, this field can be a specific month or a specific day, a specific day of the year. Okay, day of month. Okay, anything you can put in here. Instead of the filter date function, just use here the e filter dot calendar range and put here this all of this argument. Then we can get the specific season or specific suppose rainy season, two rainy season, or one dry season. We can easily combine about that and get the result about that. Just use here the e filter dot calendar range instead of filter date function.
Okay.
That's a question.
Yeah, please.
Yes, sir. I'm a bit confused with one thing. The last time you spoke about the function reduced, and today you speak about the function mosaic. So I'm still confused because the last time you said the function means reduce is to convert collection of image into a single image. And we know that in the traditional remote sensing, Mosaic is converting several bands into a single band. So I don't really understand the difference that exists between the function, the reduced function mean and mosaic.
Okay. I understand about that. Okay. So basically in this time, mosaic and median. So mainly median, when it will be combined, suppose I can get total 48 images, all of those images, similar pixel value is the combined, and make the median result. Okay. So median composite, it takes only for the middle pixel value. Okay. Is pixel is selected to have the median or middle value out of all possible values. It takes only for the middle pixel value. Okay. But when you are using here the mosaic composite, so then it will be just take all of those images. Okay. So mosaic composite, it take all of those images and make this composite. Okay. And median, it's only take the for the middle pixel value of this images and make this composite. Okay, so any confusion about
that? Another question.
Yeah, please.
After shot in the line of shot.
Yeah.
You put false.
Yeah.
What is the effect of false on the?
When I put here false, I did not use the false. Then it means that for the total 48 images, all of those cloud pixel percentage will be added in these images. Okay, but when I use the Boolean operator false, then all of those cloud pixel percentage will be removed from here. Okay, but you can see when I put here only for the cloud pixel percentage, then from 48 images, all of those pixel value will be adding with this image.
Okay, if so that I can say that false is for removing the cloud.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so now here I can get the two time period images. That says dry season and also wet season. Okay, so now from these two season, I want to observe about the NDWI. Okay, what is the condition about the NDWI in the dry season? And what is the condition of the NDWI in the wet season? I want to observe about that. So for that, first of all, I need to know about the equation, about the NDWI equation. So NDWI equation is that. In band minus near infrared divided by green plus near infrared. Okay, so I have to check the equation about that NDWI formula. Okay, these are green minus near infrared divided by green plus near infrared. So in this time, I am to implement this formula and then identify the water pixel value on the surface for the different time period, rainy season and dry season. Okay, so for that, so take a variable, suppose NDWI, suppose dry. Okay, then I simply call the dry season image. So this is the dry season image, simply copy from here and paste the dry season image. In this time, I use here the normalized difference function. Normalized difference function, put here this band name. Suppose green is that B3 and near infrared is that B8. Okay. And also do for the same way, simply copy of this line of this code and then paste in here. And put this NDWI, suppose wet. Okay, then call the wet season image. So this is the wet season image. Simply copy the variable name, image wet, and show the result in here. Okay, so now display the result. So just simply use add the map dot add layer and call the NDWI dry. Okay, now click run. In this time, one layer will be added in here without color. Okay, you can see without color will be one band will be added in here. So in this time I want to add here the color. So for that, okay, so I'll simply copy the way same way. Just okay, so make a dictionary. So put here the mean. So I put here this negative one. Put at the negative one and put at the max such as positive one. After that, I use here the color plated. Okay, so I make the color plated such as suppose put at the red color. Then put here this yellow color, then put here this green color, put here this success blue color. Okay, so now check the result about this color combination.
Bizanur.
Yeah, please.
In NDVI, you were adding blue and then white and red, and then here you use like four colors. So I wonder, so basically,
it's not any types of it's not fixed. Okay, so we can use here the color combination, three color combination or four color combination or five color combination. It's totally depend on you. So in this time, when I put here this, okay, so I use here the three color, that's better because I also, but it's not a mandatory about that. You can use any number of color for your visualization. And our main visualization we show in the ArcMap software. For after downloading these tip images, we are also go to the symbology. And then add our color plated or color gradient. We can add in our ArcMap software or QGIS software for our research paper or presentation work. Okay, but in this time we also add here the color plated, and it's not any fixed. We can use here the one color, two color, three color. But when you want to make the combination, then it will be more than three. It also better when you to make the color combination. It will be more than three color we need to use in here. Suppose in this time I use here the red color. Okay, then put here the red color, but the use here the suppose yellow color. Then put here this suppose green color, and also put here this suppose blue color. Okay, then click the run. And I also do for the same way, also for the weight season also. Then we can get the comparison between these two images. Then simply copy that weight season. And paste, and also put here the layer name. Suppose I put the layer name such as this is the NDWI dry, and also put here the NDWI for weight. NDWI weight. Okay, so in this time you can check the value. Okay, suppose I simply click on the speedo tab and click on this any water body and check about the value for the NWI. So in this time you can get the value for the NWI. In this time you can see the negative. Okay, for the NWI result when will be negative value, it's identified there is the no water. But when I can get the value for the positive, it means that it will be water. Okay, suppose I simply click on the water body in here, and I can get the two coordinate in here. You can say about the coordinate, what is the result I can got in here. So I can get the 0.1 for the dry, and for the wet season I can get the 0.3. So also increasing about the value of the NWI positive value. So when I click on here, also get in the result, you can see negative. So in this time, for this coordinate, when I want to check the pixel value, so for this dry season, there is the no water. But when I check about the wet season, here I can get the water body. Okay, positive pixel value. And in this time, it's showing look as a green color. Because in this time, I also need to reduce this value. Because you can see, our NDWI highest value is almost 0.3. Okay, 0.3. Not close to the 1 or 0.8, 0.9, okay? So almost we can get the 0.3 or 0.4, 0.5, okay? So in this time, when I reduce this value, such as 0.5, then I also get the better result for the visualization. But our range will be negative 1 to positive 1. But in this time, I put here the visualization, negative 1 to positive 0.5, okay? So let's go about that. I also put here this 0.5. Just checking the visualization, what type of vision can get in here. So in this time we can get the better visualization, and we can get the water body look as a blue color, and we can get the difference about the two layer, about the dry season and wet season. Okay, you can see the water body looking as a green color, blue color. Okay. So basically this condition showing the result for the rainy season, the first layer, in this time showing the rainy season, lot of water pixel value, you can find out in here. But when I show the result for that dry season, you can see very less. This is the rainy season, and this is the dry season. Okay, dry season will change the very less water body in here, okay, on the surface. When I want the wet season or rainy season, we can get the lot of water pixel value in here. So now, how much water pixel value increasing or decreasing? Then this type of area calculation, we also try to discuss about when I talk about the land use land cover classification map. Suppose in this time, we can get this type, how much area, water body in here, very less. But when I want to open the wet zone image, then we can get a lot of water body pixel value. Okay. So now, how much area will be increasing for the water body? So this type of analysis, this type of class I will take when I talk about that land use land cover classification and also area calculation for the different pixel value. Then I hope you can easily get the idea about that. Okay, so these are difference you can get. Okay, two types of map we can get in here, wet season and dry season. Okay, so now I want to make the time series chart about the NWI, wet season and dry season, same process. So now I talk about that time series chart. Using the same approach, we can calculate any time series chart for this satellite image. Suppose in this time you can see I use this satellite image, this, and now I want to make the time series chart. But in this time you did not make the time series chart because it has only one image. Okay, it has only one image, you can see only for the one image. But so that's why you did not make the time series chart using this time. When you want to make the time series chart, you must be make a image collection. Okay, so it's not an image collection, it's only for the single image. Time series chart is mainly work for the image collection. You must be define the image collection, then you can make the time series chart. So let's go about that. In this time I talk about the time series chart for that NWI, for the different time period, different season, as well as also make the time series chart about this type of map, get the image collection result. Okay, so any question you can ask me about that. Any question?
Yes, the question. Why is not possible to use also the force in the dry season, the wet season to remove cloud?
Yeah. Okay, but wet season is not remove the cloud because this cloud is the permanent for this images in this time. Okay, so for that we are need to use here the another approach. This approach is the cloud mask band function. Okay, for removing this type of cloud from here, we need to use here the cloud mask band function. Otherwise, this pixel of cloud is not removed. Okay, so I have to talk in the next class, inshallah, about this topic for removing the cloud using the cloud mask band function. Then I hope you can easily get the idea about that. Okay. False is not remove all of this cloud. Okay, so that's why in this time dry season, it's mainly dry season, we can get the low cloud. Okay, but rainy season, wet season, we can get a lot of cloud, and all of this cloud is not removed using the false function. So that's why we are also use a new function, cloud mask band function. Then it will be removed. Also, the cloud shed also remove all of this will be removed. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So anyone any question about that? Okay, so now talk about the time series chart, how we can easily make the time series chart using this type of satellite images. Okay, so first of all, I try to show you this image. So in this time, time series chart is not possible because it's the single image. Time series chart mainly when we get the image collection, then it will be work. Okay, so let's go about that. In this time, we are just make the image collection. So that's why I simply use the filter metadata and select the specific cloud cover less than 0.5, and take all of those images and make the median composite and clip with my shapefile is that ROI. Okay, so now in this time I want to observe for the Dhaka city, so just import the Dhaka city shapefile and remove my previous ROI and put this as a ROI. So put here the ROI. Okay, so now this result I get for my region of interest, Dhaka city. Click to run. Okay, I also need to map.center object of Dhaka city boundary shapefile. Map.center object for focusing on the center of this Dhaka city. ROI. And I'm click to run. So now we can get the result about this. We can get this map, satellite images, and also get all of those layer. So basically this time we also had a lot of way for showing the result, lot of way. So that's why a lot of layer also added in here, but we can see the result only for, yeah. So this is the NDVI result. So in this time I want to make this time about this. So now I want to make this NDVI map for this region. I think somebody has